Time of the evening. It is main event time. It is the Green Machine, Mike Orlando, challenging Lance Anoa'i for the WXW C4 Ultimate Heavyweight Championship.
You're absolutely right, Salamander Jones. You know, over the years, we have seen a lot of men come and go in this organization, and we've seen a lot of men chase after Lance when he's had that title. And I'll tell you what, Mike Orlando right here, very well may be one of the most strongest opponents that Lance Anoa'i very well might be defending that title against tonight.
Absolutely, Mike Orlando, as we know, 275 pounds, stands about 6'4". He was a former NFL runner-up. He was a college standout in football. And this young man is very intense, very strong, and very focused. And what he wants is to walk out of here, WXW C4 Ultimate Heavyweight Champion.
I gotta tell you, one good thing about Mike Orlando is I guarantee you, when he does his laundry, there's no disputing which shirt is his.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
There you go. There you go, Doc Daniels. We'll give you that one. Absolutely. Right? Right? Yeah, yes. Yes, you're absolutely right.
Steps through, comes up with a hammerlock of his own. And Orlando, very carefully, trying to keep his head out of the reach of Lance Anoa'i. Anoa'i trying to reach back and perhaps execute a snap and escape from this maneuver.
Oh, and here we go. And Lance, once again, now does the turnaround. He now has Orlando in a nice headlock. Standing headlock right here. And Lance going into the ropes. Up and over, and Lance up and over. Look at this. Oh, and a nice shoulder block from Armstrong taking him down.
There is that size and power coming into play of Mike Orlando. Oh, looks like Lance Anoa'i was able to trip him up, and it almost cost Orlando there. He's able to catch his footing at the very last second.
Right, my mistakes, fans, my mistakes. I accidentally misspoke and referred to him. I don't know what the hell. Yes, my
goal. It's your attention to detail that really just makes you head and shoulders.
Hey, will you knock it off, Salamander Jones? It's tough enough sitting here next to you when we gotta do these damn things. I don't need any grief from you on top of it, all right?
Sure, she loved me. Back to the matchup.
Well, we see you. Both men are kind of in a stare down. Punches are being thrown. This may just have turned into an all-out fight. In your opinion, who does that benefit?
Well, you know, I'll tell you, I think I might have to go with Orlando in this one, definitely for the size advantage. That's really a tough call. Salamander Jones?
Well, I mean, to be honest, let's think about this one here. Obviously, the Green Machine, Mike Orlando, an incredible specimen. But Lance Anoa'i, think about some of the people we've seen him stand toe-to-toe with. Men like Dan Moss. You know, it doesn't get any bigger and tougher. And Lance has managed to get his hand raised in victory over opponents the likes of Dan Moss.
You know who I am! That's a really good point. An excellent point, Salamander Jones. Doc?
The only thing here is that while you do make good points, this is something that Lance is not accustomed to. He's either wrestling someone that's about his size or smaller, where it's an all-out aerial battle, or he's wrestling a guy that may be bigger than him, which turns into you're relying more on your fighting abilities and your technical expertise. However, in this case, you get both out of Mike Orlando.
Very true. Mike Orlando definitely is the total package, much like Lance. It's a tough call. This is really quite the battle. Time is going to tell on this one.
See how important this belt is to them. Both men kicking out at one, not even allowing themselves to get anywhere near that. That's how important this match is. And let me tell you, after taking some of these moves early on, you kick out and you don't take that extra second to catch your breath, it could ultimately end up.
Lance Anoa'i really opening up here, and he is in control of this matchup. Orlando looking a bit dazed and confused here. And Lance using that headbutt.
He's so well known for. This is my sound.
Trying to shake up the cobwebs here. And look at this. Up and over. Tremendous athleticism from the green machine.
I was talking about right here.
Huh? Let's go, boy.
There was some on that stage.
A height difference between Lance and Orlando, too. That is, look at that beautiful spinning edge by Mike Orlando. Going back to my point with the height difference. Beautiful spear into the corner. Running knee right to the jaw, Lance Anoa'i. We could have a new champion here to cover. There again.
There's that toughness of Lance Anoa'i, that determination coming into play here. Like we said, the man has been to this dance many a time against many a tough competitor, and he is not going to go gently into that good night here against a machine like Orlando.
Oh, you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Salamander Jones, Doc Daniels makes a very good point about both of these men wanting this title, not getting past. One count when pin attempts are being made. Look at this Lance right now in that damn Samoan drop. Look at that. Executed right there in the middle of that ring. Salamander Jones, I've seen that move so many times in the last 20 years, and it's always the beginning of the end for the opponent when you see that happening. And look at this, Orlando Attaboy.
You're seeing the smarts of the green machine like Orlando coming to play. He immediately rolled out of the ring to create some separation. And when he saw Lance on the move, he tried to get out of dodge. Lance, though, fouled him to the outside and swinging wildly with those right hands.
Match being taken out to the outside. Orlando's head thrusted upon the steel barricade. And that may have hurt just as much as taking a headbutt from the one. I know.
These damn crazy Samoans, man. They're crazy inside the ring. They're crazy outside the ring. You know, you never know what the hell you're going to get. Salamander Jones?
Right now, Mike Orlando is catching a beating here from Lance Anoa'i. Lance is taking this to the next level.
Orlando leading foot first into the face of Lance Anoa'i.
Absolutely, those stomps very reminiscent of a certain former WWF champion. Mike Orlando throwing his full weight into the chest of Lance Anoa'i.
Cover here by Orlando. This time Lance kicking out at two. Now we see that was the first time the referee was able to get to two. So what that indicates is Lance is starting to feel it. Lance needed that extra second to catch his breath, to let his body figure out where he was. So Orlando is now in striking distance.
Absolutely. Orlando taking a little second off. An extra second as you put it in. And now, Lance Anoa'i is struggling to get to his feet. And Orlando, look at the confidence on the face of the Green Machine. Lance Anoa'i, though, throwing those back elbows.
Here comes Lance off the ropes, but eats an elbow and goes down. Again, the cover. Lance again kicks out. You can see the frustration on Orlando's face.
You got to wonder if Orlando there was able to get better body-on-body contact, perhaps hook that leg, and that would have been the difference in that moment. And now Mike Orlando trying to figure out what his next move is. Tell the official to get out of the way. Oh, and a big slingshot splash on the Lance Anoa'i. And a very arrogant cover is not able to keep Lance down for the three.
Absolutely. Lance Anoa'i certainly getting the kick out of the two from that power move from Orlando. Unbelievable. These guys are really taking it from pillar to post with each other. And, you know, I'll tell you, it's just simply amazing. This clearly is one, I think, going to be one of the best matches in either of these young men's careers.
Lance has an entire future ahead of him. And if the gene pool proves anything, what it proves is it makes stars.
Cool snap suplex from Lance Anoa'i. He takes Orlando over. A lot of velocity on that. This is giving Lance a couple of moments to catch his breath to try and get himself back into this one.
Lance bringing a little heavy, maybe not coming in as strong as he wanted to, which allowed Orlando to get that boot up and drive into the face. Young smoke.
Relations, folks. Man.
Wow. Wow. Here we go. Orlando's got him rolled up. One, two. Has got to be frustrated as all hell to try to figure out why he can't get Lance in the 1-2-3 and be done with it. So many champions, so many greats here in C4 and wrestling all over the world.
One of the greatest, possibly one of the most powerful and influential enemy that Lance and the entire Anoa'i clan has had is me.
Well, Lance sending Orlando across.
Wow.
Orlando tried to go up and over. Lance had him scouted, and that super kick caught him right in the mush. Lance is down. Orlando is down. It's gut check time.
Here we go. Who's got it?
Lance rolling over now, as is Orlando. They're ready to go at it again here.
You hear the Green Machine, Mike Orlando, yelling into Lance's face, "I hate you."
I did pick up on that.
There is some real animosity in this ring right now.
These guys just exchanging, punch after punch, exchanging. Lance now with a series of at least three, now four, keeping Orlando into the corner and now bringing him out. Lance gearing up for a huge splash into the corner, sending Orlando for the ride.
And there's that running knee. Orlando scrambling to the corner. And I think he scrambled into the running part of town. There's that Samoan hip attack.
That's what you call it, a hip attack.
Absolutely. Oh, look at this. had Orlando way too close to the ropes. Orlando able to realize where he was, able to realize his ring positioning, and grab the ropes, forcing the break.
It was a veteran like move by the young Mike Orlando.
Absolutely. Lance going for that moonsault. Orlando able to get out of the way.
This may be Orlando's opening to end this match. Picks him up. What's he looking for?
Oh, wow. Hellacious Ghostbuster.
Wow. That elevation, falling right onto the knees of Orlando, takes all the air out of the young Samoan. If you can't breathe, you can't kick out. German suplex to the bridge.
Orlando is pulling out all the stops there. And like Borgai said earlier, Orlando has got to be at this point wondering what it's going to take to put away Lance Anoa'i.
Oh, yeah. I'm still wondering it. I'm still wondering. It's amazing. It really is. You know, I'll tell you what. In 20 years, I've had a lot of beef with the Samoans and the whole Anoa'i tribe and the, you know, the whole nine yards. But you know what? When it boils down to it, I got to give credit to that young man. I've seen Lance. I grew up with that man. I've watched that young man grow into the man he is today. And I'll tell you what, very few SOBs are as tough as that young man right there. So I'll give it to Lance, man. Absolutely.
An incredible athletic moonsault attempt there by Orlando. And this time it was Lance's turn to get out of the way. Lance picking Orlando up. Look at this. Oh, the official.
Catches breath.
Now I could be the champion by now.
Anything is possible, ball guy. You know that.
Orlando has leveled many a man with that O-line. That is his signature maneuver. And you got to believe it was only the fact that the official was down that Lance was able to kick out after this brutal matchup that has taken place between these two gentlemen. Lance finds the island cutter. Going for the cover now. That inside leg, and Orlando kicking out. Orlando kicking out of the island cutter. And now it's Lance's turn to be stunned and amazed and wonder what he's got to do to retain his championship. Ooh,
without a doubt. And I'll tell you what, if Lance makes his way up to that top turnbuckle and comes off that flying headbutt, goddamn you, you know how that'll end.
Lance taking off his gold, but look at that beautiful, beautiful European uppercut. Takes Lance off his feet and straddling the turnbuckle.
I hate you.
Orlando followed it up with that big right hand. Now he's putting the bad mouth on Lance Anoa'i. Perhaps setting him up for a big superplex there.
You want to call it big, look at the height of that man.
Absolutely. He's got him cinched up. But Lance battling back. Series of shots to the ribs. And there's those headbutts in the turnbuckle, guy.
I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you.
Orlando goes crashing down. Lance now on top. Get ready to take that leap. Beautiful splash. The cover. And that is it.
Jones, you may love him, you may hate him, no matter how you feel, undeniably, Lance Anoa'i is still the WXW C4 Heavyweight Champion.
Absolutely tremendous victory for young Lance Anoa'i over a very game, the Green Machine, Mike Orlando. And I gotta tell you, I'm sure we will see Mike Orlando back here in C4 once again. Most likely challenging for that very championship again, because he put on one hell of a display here tonight. But I'll tell you what, it's been an incredible night here at WXW C4, an awesome night of action. Folks, you gotta make sure to check out WXWC4.com for the next time we'll be here in Mountainville Memorial Hall. You gotta come here, you gotta see this action live. And I wanna thank Doc Daniels for joining us here tonight. Of course, my partner, the bald guy. And for everyone here at WXWC4, I'm Salamander Jones. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time. Good night and get home safe.